Hello, and welcome to Color Art Emotion and to a new video on sketching and painting with watercolor, an architectural scene. In this video, you will see the full process, analyzing the scene, sketching, painting, and refining. Enjoy! If you are new to the channel and interested in sketching and painting, consider subscribing. So, we just took a quick look at the scene analysis to get an overview and get a bit familiarized with this beautiful Baroque church. This was our first step, our first interaction with the scene. We are going to do a simple pencil sketch. The purpose of this pencil sketch is to start placing the subject on the paper and to be careful about the composition and about the proportions. I think this is a very important step because we have to look at the building as a whole and understand how the elements are connected in order to translate this on our paper. The first thing is to assure that the entire building will fit on the paper. For this, we will start by drawing two lines that are delimiting the lower part, the base, and the top of the lantern. Between these two lines will be the entire church. The next thing is to find a unit that will help us in maintaining good proportions. I think that a good measuring unit is the height of the lantern. By looking and comparing, we can try to see what parts of the church are bigger or smaller than the measuring unit, and how much bigger or how much smaller. At the beginning, it will be very hard, but with practice, you will be able to do this fairly quickly, only by looking. It's only a matter of practicing. Let's look a bit at the dome, because this is a very important and beautiful component of the building. We know that domes have rounded parts, and in perspective, this will translate by drawing ellipses. Another specific element is the fact that the dome has repeating parts or slices. Happens both because it looks more beautiful and organized, but also because of a constructive factor. Every slice is supported by ribs or beams. This repetition creates a rhythm of windows and columns. At this step, we don't need to have a finished looking drawing. But we do need to have in place the main shapes with realistic proportions. This sketch will guide us through the next step, the inking part. Thank you. Now it's time to do our final drawing with waterproof ink. We can look more focused on specific areas and build up more details and information. Now, we can start to draw windows and columns. Be careful to suggest the depth of the windows. This will make the drawing look better. Don't forget to bring your personal taste on how many or few details you decide to add to the drawing. Now, I will let you enjoy this part and come back again in a few minutes at the watercolor part. we can start painting our scene with watercolor. On the right, you can see the names of the pigments I am using. Feel free to use your favorite colors. My idea with this sketch was to do it quite fast and hopefully to obtain a fresh look. I also tried to somehow make the viewer observe the sketch diagonally, starting up from the dome to the people on the ground, or from the people up to the dome, and to find in the trees somehow an area of rest, not an area full of details. The main used colors are burnt sienna with French ultramarine, rose sienna with cobalt blue, and a bit of cobalt turquoise, pyrrole red, and rose. You will find more details and text notes along the process. Thank you. After the watercolor dried, I came back with the pen and added a few dark accents to suggest more decorative elements and increase the contrast. You can also add white accents with white paint, but as I was afraid of overworking the sketch, I chose not to add white accents this time. I really hope you have enjoyed this video and found helpful information inside. In the description below, you'll find a list with all my art supplies. Let me know if you like this video and if you have further questions or suggestions for the channel. Also, don't forget to hit the notification bell if you haven't already. Take care, have a great day, and see you in the next video!